Screenshot. Join these people. All right, welcome to the Pair 10K Shareathon. This is regular. All right, let's get this in place. Thanks for coming in. Welcome. Thanks for joining me. Let's get set up shop here properly. Thanks for coming in. Welcome. If you're here for the first time, this is the Pair 10K. Amy, nice to be here. You're after me, so good to be in the scope. This is the Pair 10K Shareathon, and please do me a favor and shout this out far and wide over Periscope, Twitter, and Facebook, because my Periscope's messed up somehow and they're trying to fix it for me and it's not working. So you don't get notified when I'm doing it. Nice to be here, Amy. Good to see you. It's funny, today's running order is almost the same as it was last time I was leading the group, except for one change, which is great. So anyway, I'll get to that in a minute. Thanks for coming in. Welcome. Come on in the room. Just got notified because it's sluggish from my end. The Twitter Periscope thing isn't broken in my Periscope for some reason and it hasn't been fixed yet and they're trying to fix it. Or I should say, they keep giving me questions to answer and I keep telling them the same thing. It ain't working. Daniel, nice to have you here, sir. Ah, there you are. Good to see you, Brooke. I love it that we're in the same scope this time, since we finally met in person. So I'll talk about that in a moment too. On Periscope, etc. Yeah. Welcome, thanks for coming in. Please share with your friends and followers on Twitter and Periscope and on Facebook. This is what's coming up. This is the Pair 10K Shareathon. Notice, I'll get to the thing in red in a moment. Shh, don't tell anybody, it's a secret. Today's topic's getting interesting because it's a Friday and we're doing meditation tips that might not seem like meditation. I almost thought it wasn't going to fit in the title for my scope, but it did just. I had to shave some things off to make it fit. So, let you know what's coming up. Basically, for those of you who don't know, let me tell you about your running order. Hi, nice to have you here, Catchy. Catchy that she's the last one in this first round. She'll be handing over to the second round. I'll give you that moment. So, Pair 10K, which is one of my favorite groups on Facebook. I must admit, I do have a second bias now, which is Pair Dudes, and I'll tell you about that another time. Not part of this scope. Pair 10K rocks. And what we do, as part of our loving service to the world, is we do a share-a-thon every day, 7 days a week. Monday through Friday, it's a two-round share-a-thon. Saturday and Sunday, usually it's one extended round each day. But on the weekdays, like today, we do a share-a-thon that runs for 2 hours. Time for that, in case you're wondering, I'm not Canadian, I'm English. Unless you want somebody else in there, I'm not sure. Perry 10... Catchy, I'm not handsome, you're talking to Daniel about this? Fine. nice to have you here. Perry 10K does a share-a-thon twice each weekday. And this is the first round of that. So yes, please make sure you invite your friends, share and inspire people. I'm trying to get this done in a minute so I can get into my topic. We do a topic theme each time. And we have usually 5 people in a row in each of the 2 hours, sometimes 6, depending how it fits, going the same topic. So let me give you information. Yes, it is a great group indeed. So here it is, Pair 10K Shareathon. And by the way, I'll just cover the piece in red now because I'll talk about it later. Pair10k.com/app. Not join. App, yes. This time next week, Friday next week, we are having the Pair 10K app launched in the App Store. That is off the chain amazing, so I'll let you know about that in a moment. It's going to be a place you find out all about Periscope. Just basically go to pair10k.com/app, find out all about it. Get on the waiting list so you know about it when it gets announced. You can help promote the app on Friday next week to boost it in the App Store. That's on Friday the 6th, 5th, it's going to be. So anyway, this is the Shareathon round one. Meditation tips that might not seem like meditation. Ooh. And as you can see in the list running order, and most of the people are here, I think I've seen Amy come in, I've seen Brooke, and I've seen Catchy. I'm waiting for Timby. I haven't seen Timby yet. Maybe I just didn't see her in the list. But this is the running order. Myself, I'm taking off top of the hour, like now, the first 10 minutes, then Amy at 10 after, then Timby at 20 after, then Brooke at top at the bottom of the hour, at 30 after, Catchy at 40, we'll then take it up to, Timby's here, good. Just want to double check. So each of the speakers are here. So here's the deal. We're going to talk about meditation, but not the way you think. At least, maybe not. We'll see. If you're just joining us, thanks for coming in, and please heart blast, lots of hearts. Please share. Make sure you follow me on Periscope because I do talk every day. There she is. Nice to see you, Timby. And if you are one of the speakers in the first hour, which means Amy, Timby, Brooke, and Catchy, please make sure up some emojis so they know to follow you individually in this scope, and then I'll be handing over to Amy in about 8 minutes. So, all right, so Amy, Timby, Brooke, and Catchy, if you post up some emojis now and say you're a speaker, that way people know if they're watching, you'll be able to follow. There's one, that's Kimby, she's coming up third. And then, well, so I can read through the emojis. That's catchy. She's going to be the fifth one. And let's see if the other ones. So I'm waiting for Brooke and for Amy to post up some emojis. Oh, you're way too rich. Not a roving question. There's Amy who's up second. She's up right after me. And there's Bella. Caramel Bella. That's Brooke. So that's everybody in. Okay. So let's get going on this. So today's about meditation, not about money. Meditation. And I've got the advantage. I'm going first. I can pick anything I want. But I'm gonna keep it simple. And hopefully it won't steal from anybody else's thunder who's coming up after me. And again, you're gonna get through the next 2 hours, basically at least 10 or 11 different keys to help meditation. How cool is that? So yeah, good question, Catchy. Have you shared yet? Share this on your friends and followers on Periscope and Twitter and Facebook. Okay, I'm gonna make this really simple. One of the simplest tips I know that doesn't seem like meditation, but isn't like meditation, is this. That simple. As in literally, one breath in, one breath out. If you can do that mindfully, this is the key, mindfully, as in you stop what you're doing, you stop running around craziness, and you're not doing it because you're panting, because you've been exercising or running or anything else. You just stand or sit or be still on the bus, in the car, at the traffic signal, or at home, and you simply go, actually, through the nose is better. Breathe in and breathe out. That simple an action will bring you present. That simple an action will still your mind for a moment, just for a moment. Now, there are many meditation practices that are breathing based, that are very conscious, some are very fast, very slow, there's all sorts of variations. I'm not teaching that. What I'm saying is a tip for meditation that will help you get still and present, which for me, a large part of meditation is to be present and to let go of what's going around you. If you can be conscious enough, and you do breathe all the time, obviously, as you fall over, but if you do breathe with intention, as in instead of just going all the way through life and you're realizing, I've been breathing like this for the last, 4 days without realizing it, but you bring consciousness to the breath, bring it back here, that's part of the biggest pieces of meditation right there. Okay, I'm done. No, it's like 3 minutes after the hour. I've got another seven to fill. Meditation is something that varies for many people. So I'm just going to talk about some things first to give you also some context because there are different forms. Oh, you know what? This is what I need to talk about. It just came through. I forgot about this piece. This is a philosophical piece about meditation and hopefully a teaching point for many of you who don't know this. Ooh, what could it be? What could it be? So if you are watching this, thank you for being here, by the way. Yes, meditation. There are so many different meditation flavors and forms out there. And again, you've got four wonderful folks, beautiful ladies after me teaching about this, and then a whole second hour full of people teaching you meditation tips that do not seem that might not seem like meditation. So here's a piece that you may not know about. Are you aware that when you sit still and your arms are on your lap and you're sitting quietly in peace and you're not moving, that form of meditation, you know that's actually not. That's called masculine meditation. Yes, masculine meditation. You know there's a difference. There's masculine meditation and there's feminine meditation. They're like, there is? What is this? Tell me more. Meditation is obviously for the same result, which is to bring yourself present, bring yourself in, be aware of the greater life that you are and who you are. And so there's still the mind pretty present. Sitting meditation is actually a meditation practice for men. So what is it for women? I'll get to that. I'm gonna make sure I give you content that's valuable, not just saying breathe in, breathe out. It's like it's too easy. I'll tell you what it is and then explain why in a moment. I'm trying to sorry, I'm just it came through, so I'm trying to break down what is coming through to give you value. So sitting still, breathe, doing nothing is a masculine practice. The opposite is feminine, which means yoga and dance, movement exercise type things are actually a feminine meditation practice. Yep, they're different. And people are going, what? Huh? The expression, the distillation, the energetic of the masculine and feminine is very different. The masculine expression, this is part of my coaching and teaching work, so I'm just giving you a piece of my work in this context because it fits. Men in the masculine, our power is in our presence, our stillness, our consciousness. That's a gift we can serve the feminine with by holding a space and being present to you ladies. The feminine energetic the expression of, is in movement, and in movement and going and dance. Thank you, 5 minutes. That's perfect. That is supported by feminine movement type meditation. So yoga, dancing are for a lot of women. There are certain dance forms, certainly I know in Los Angeles and other places too on the West Coast. One's called the five rhythms. There's also, what's it called? There's another dance environment that is, I've got the name of it. Oh, it'll come back to me. But the name come back to me. Sorry, I'm reaching for the name, it's not coming back. But basically what it is for women who, well, it's for everybody, but I think women really need it more. Where it's basically a form of dancing that is absolutely getting them in the body, movement, energetic, all over the place. This is feminine power. No, not Zumba, it's not a structured dance. It's actually a very free-form dance. And a friend of mine has it, and I've got the name come back to me. Not hula, that's another form of non-structure. I like the ideas, though. Thank you for the ideas. I'm just remembering what it is, like, it'll come back to me. It's like something that's sensual. No. It's okay. The bottom line is this. For the masculine and the feminine, there are two different forms of meditative practice that work most ideally for that gender, or for that pole. Oh, right. That's just... in a way, yes. I won't argue with that. Is that Miel, how you say that? I actually have friends of mine who do pole dancing as a form of... exercise and strength. Ecstatic dance, that's the one, thank you. Oh, finally it hit me. Ecstatic dance, that was the word. It was in there somewhere. Thank you for that, and I missed who said that, so sorry. Thank you for catching that. Was that you, Timby, who did that one? I couldn't see who did it. Yeah, that format, even though men go to it, I think, to be honest, to see the women, it's really for feminine. Because feminine movement is dancing, and Linda knows about this stuff, I believe. You've done some work on this stuff. So, yeah, that I didn't realize it was coming through until I just started talking about it. So that's the format I lead. Yeah, exactly. Okay, great. So again, masculine meditation is sitting still, sit down, hands on, open posture. That's a masculine practice. That's why the Buddha sits like that. For women, you're a fitness pole. There you go. And I respect that a lot, because actually a lot of women I know, I recommend for feminine practice, do pole, because it brings you back in your body in a way of strength, of power. So it's not about the sexiness or all that stuff. It's about owning your flow. So I've got like 1 minute left. So Amy, please put those emojis. You're going up in like a minute, 2 minutes. So they know to follow you, because you're going up after me. And so back to the beginning. So if you join in late, I just covered more than I planned. One tip I was going to say for sealant meditation is to take one slow breath in, one slow breath out. Is it just you? Do I look like Sean Connery? I grew this not to look like him, but just who I am. And he had more hair. Well, he had more wig than I did. And he's Scottish, I'm English. Different. So thanks for the compliment, though. I'll take that. Sean Connery was a good-looking guy. He is a good-looking guy. So good question, Ketchy. Did they tap 500 hearts? I don't know. There's Amy. She with the hearts in her emoji. She's going up next. And she's going up in like a minute or 30 seconds or so. So if you want to go set up, and I'll be along to follow you as soon as you're ready. And somebody let me know when she goes live, because she should go live in about 30 seconds. So again, back to the beginning. One simple meditation tip I can recommend highly is to simply stop and through the nose take a deep breath in and deep breath out. Wherever you can find time to do that, not when you're driving, but when you're stationary, key. But if you're in a stressful situation, or if you're in a boardroom meeting, or if you're stuck in traffic, or if you're sitting at home, or if you hear some news that disturbs your peace, a deep breath in, a deep breath out can bring you present. And as you put in a meditative state, it doesn't take a lot. Yes, you should sit for 20 minutes if you want to do that. That's your choice. And again, as I mentioned in the scope, which I go back and watch because I broke it down in more detail, a masculine practice is sitting still. A feminine practice of meditation is moving. Not what you think. So for women in the feminine, meditation could be dancing or yoga, because it tunes them into their feminine nature, which is healthy. So try that one on for size. So that's it. That's my scope, and again, as a reminder, we are doing a share-a-thon. And this is the share-a-thon running order for the first hour, because there's 2 hours of this stuff coming up. So you've got four more ladies coming up for me who are going to teach their ideas and keys for meditation for you as well, so check them out. Right now, Amy's going up after me, and she'll be going live any second now, followed by Timby, and you can see the handles there to follow, the Dirty Southern. Brooke Sydney's after that, my newest in-person Periscope friend, who I only met on Wednesday. Caramabella and Ketchy. Oh, you're welcome, you're welcome. And then Ketchy, honestly, Ketchy is going up at 40 after the hour. Amy is live, thank you, Ketchy. So I'm switching across to her. So thanks for following me. Whoops. Double tap, there you go. And make sure you follow my scopes and follow me. It's been fun to do. This one actually came out better. I was thinking, what did I talk about for 10 minutes about meditation? Breathe? That doesn't take 10 minutes. Well, apparently it did. Thanks for watching. Thanks for following me. I'm going to go pop out now and go follow Amy. Make sure you're following me so that way you'll be notified when I'm inviting you to follow her. All right? Thanks for watching. Appreciate your time. Take care of yourselves and try meditating. It's fun. See you later. Bye.